First time looking at something like this. Am I supposed to do a substitution that twice? Or should I take anything out? Well, let's have a look. Here we are going to integrate tangent of inverse sine of x over square root of 1 minus x squared. Yes, you can do substitution twice, but it's going to be pretty long. I will show you the steps though. First, you let u equal to the inside, sine inverse of x, and then differentiate this, you see we get 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared. And this is very nice, because these two together will give us the du right away. But then, after the substitution, once you get to the u world, you get to integral of tangent of u, du. If you know the standard result, you can just quote that. If not, you will have to write tangent u as sine u over cosine u du and do another substitution to figure this out. And then right here, you may use w, and you can just let w equal to cosine u, and then dw is going to be negative sine u du, and then this right here is positive, right? We want negative, so just negative, negative, right? Multiply negative and divide by negative. It's going to be quite long. Plus, if you finish all this, at the end, the answer is actually not in the most simplified form. You will still have to simplify that answer. So a much better way is, try to simplify the expression in the beginning, before you do any calculus. Alright, so don't do that. Here's the deal. Whenever we have a trig function, and then inside it's an inverse trig function, we can always write this as a radical expression. Let me show you. So, here's my note. Just focus on tangent inverse sine of x. This right here, for the inside, I'm just going to say, okay, inverse trig function represents an angle. I'm just going to call that theta. That theta equal to inverse sine of x. Now what does this do? This means we can look at this as the original sine of theta equals x. And we know when we have sine, the definition of sine on a right triangle is opposite over hypotenuse. So if we have x, let's look at that as x over 1. This right here will be the opposite side, and this right here will be the hypotenuse. Based on this information, we can draw a right triangle. Put the right angle here, and then the angle theta here. Label the x right here, and the hypotenuse is right here. And let's solve the triangle by figuring out this side. And the easy way to do this is you open the square root, and then you do the hypotenuse, the longest side right here in the triangle, right? The hypotenuse right here, square that, and then minus the other side square. Now that's the fast way. If you want to figure out the hypotenuse, you do the square root, and then it's going to be the sum of squares inside, but maybe for another video. But it's just the Pythagorean theorem, so you can work that out. And then once you look at this triangle, we're trying to figure out tangent of the angle. So as you can see, tangent of the angle theta is just going to be opposite over adjacent, which is just x over square root of 1 minus x squared. 1 squared is 1. So now let's go by there. Instead of looking at tangent of inverse sine x, let's change that. This is just the integral of that on the top, so x over square root of 1 minus x squared, and then over that square root of 1 minus x squared dx. Good, huh? Now let's clean this up a little bit. Multiply the top and bottom by square root of 1 minus x squared, because this way you can see this and that cancel. You pretty much just bring this down and then multiply with that. And then you are looking at the integral of x on the top over, what do we get when we have square root of this times the square root of the same thing? Just the inside, right? Yeah. So we just look at the integral of x over 1 minus x squared dx. And now, can we just do a nice u sub? Yes. That u equal to what? The denominator, right? The whole thing, denominator. 1 minus x squared, because you can see, when we differentiate this, derivative of 1 is 0, derivative of negative x squared is negative 2x dx. And I like to show people the cancellation, so let me divide the negative 2x on both sides. We see dx equals du over negative 2x. Now take this integral to the u world. This is the integral. X is x over that is our u. Dx is du over negative 2x. This and that cancel. Very nice, isn't it? We have a 1 over negative 2. Let's put it outside. And then look at the integral of 1 over u in the u world. Well, integrating that, let's just put down negative 1 over 2. Integrating 1 over u, we get ln. And then u, right? U is what? That. 1 minus x squared. This thing can be negative, so be careful. We must have an absolute value around this. So that's pretty much the answer. I'll put down a plus c right here. Sorry about the tension. So that will be the answer. So hopefully this right here helps. Of course, if you would like to see more integration tutorial, I have tons of videos. You can check out this video right here for 100 integrals. That's it.